Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we studied what is prime factorization and two methods of prime factorization, correct? So first was the factor tree method and the next one was the division method. So in today's class we will see what is LCM. Okay, so before that let's just revise what is prime factorization. So when a number is written as a product of its factors, then a number is said to be factorized. So whenever you write a number as a product of its factors, then it is said to be factorized. So there can be more than one way of factorizing a number. So here they've taken an example for 45. So 45 can be factorized as 1 into 45 or 3 into 15 or 5 into 9. Okay, or it can also be factorized as 3 into 3 into 5. Now here when you observe in this last way, that is 3 into 3 into 5, 3 and 5 both are prime numbers. Okay, so when you factorize a number such that it is a product of prime factors alone, then it is called as prime factorization. Okay, so there can only be one set of prime factors for any given number. Alright, there can be multiple other factorizations, but prime factors can be only one set. Okay, so this is 3 into 3 into 5 for 45. Alright, so we saw the different methods. The first was the factor tree method. So we saw an example for 56. So first what we did, we wrote the 56 as a product of known factors, which is 7 into 8. Now here 7 is a prime, correct? 7 is prime, but 8 is a composite number. So we'll factorize 8 forward again as 2 into 4. Now here 2 is a prime number but 4 is a composite number, so we'll factorize 4 again as 2 into 2. Okay, so now we got all the prime factors, correct? So thus 56 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 7. Okay, and note that prime numbers are enclosed in circles and composite numbers are within rectangles. So we saw different examples for factor tree method, correct? Then next we saw what is called as the division method. So in the division method, we start dividing the number by small prime number divisors. So here 48 is there, so the smallest prime number is 2, so we'll start dividing it by 2. Now we'll write 2 here, and you know that 2 2s are 4 and 2 4s are 8, correct? So it will be 24. Now 24 is further divided by 2 again. So that is 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Okay, so we got 12 now. We know that 2 6s are 12. So we'll write 6 here. And 2 3s are 3. So we'll write 3. Now 3 is a prime number. So you don't need to divide any further. So you have to continue till you arrive at a prime number dividend. Okay, so these are the dividends here, which are written on the left hand side. Sorry, on the right hand side, which is written, those are the dividends. Now here we got 3. So 3 is a prime number, so we will not divide it any further. So the prime factors for 48 will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, so this is division method. So we solved various examples or questions from the textbook. Correct. So now we'll study what is LCM. So LCM is nothing but it is the lowest common multiple. Okay, so LCM of a set of numbers is the smallest number that can be exactly divided by each of the given numbers without leaving a remainder. Okay, so it is between a set of numbers, it will be the smallest number that is common among that set of multiples. Okay, so you can see we'll determine LCM by various methods. Okay, we can determine LCM by various methods. First is by listing the multiples of the given numbers, or by prime factorization method, which you have studied, or common division method. So let's try to find LCM by these three methods. So first we'll do by listing common multiples. Okay, so list a few multiple and hence find the LCM of 8 and 12. So they are asking to find the multiples of 8 and 12. So for first what you will do, you will write the first few multiples of 8. So for your reference, you can write the first 10 multiples of 8 okay, or the 8 tables. So here we have 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, 48 and 56. Okay, then you can write the multiples of 12, which are 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, and you can go on. Okay, but here if you see now, it between both the sets, one set is multiples of 8, another is multiples of 12. So between both the sets, we have two common multiples. One is 24, another is 30, 48. Correct. So 24 and 48 are the common multiples of 8 and 12. But the lowest common multiple or the LCM will be lowest among these. Okay. Between 24 and 48, which is the lowest or the smallest, it is 24. So LCM of 8 and 12 is 24. Okay. So this is how you find LCM by listing multiples. Okay. Then next we have another method, that is by prime factorization method. Okay, so here they have told find the LCM of 45 and 60 by prime factorization method. So here what we can do is, by division method, you can first find prime factors of both 45 and 60. So first finding prime factors of 45. So now we know that the lowest prime number or the smallest prime number is 2, but 45 cannot be divided by 2, so we'll start with the next smallest prime number, which is 3. So we have 3 ones are 3, then 1 will remain here, correct? So 3 5s are 15, sorry, the 3 5s are 15, so 15 is there here now. Now again 3 5s are 15, now 5 is a prime number, so we'll stop the division here. Then we'll do 6. We'll find prime factors for 60 by division method. So now we'll take 2 3s are 6 and then 2 0s are 0. Then 2 1s are 2. Okay, so 1 will remain here. Then 2 5s are 10. Then we'll do 3 5s are 15. So here we have prime factors for 45 is 3 into 3 into 5. And prime factors for 60 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now here if you see the common factors, or taking each set of common factors. Okay, so here we have 3 one time, 3 two times, but here we have 3 one time in 60. So we'll write this 3 together as a common factor. Okay, so we'll write it only once. Then here we have another 3, correct? So we'll write that 3. So 2 into 2, okay, LCM will be 2 into 2, then into 3, into 3 into 5. Okay, there are two 5s, but since 5 is both common for both 45 and 60, we'll write it only once. Okay, and 3 is common one time for both the numbers, so we'll write it two times. Okay, so this one time which is common and one which is not common, we'll write it once again. So taking each set of common factors, that is the colored digits, okay, once, and all the other factors that are not common. So we get 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. So the LCM is 180. Okay. So alternatively, 2 occurs twice in 60, 3 occurs twice in 45, and 5 occurs once. Correct. So 5 occurs once equally in both 45 and 60. So LCM is 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Alright. So that was LCM by prime factorization method. So we'll understand when we solve the problems. Okay. Next we have find LCM of LCM by common division method. So common division method is quite similar to your division method, but here we will divide both the numbers that they've asked us to find LCM for together. So it can either be two or more numbers. Okay, so first, now the example is find LCM of 24 and 30 by common division method. So we'll write 24 and 30 like this, how we write it in common division. Okay, so we'll start dividing by 2. So list the numbers with commas in between as shown. Divide each number by 2, the smallest prime number. So we have 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4. Then for 30 we have 2 ones are 2, and so 3 minus 2 will be 1. So here we'll have 1, and 2 fives are is 10. So it will be 15. So you divide, okay, so we divide separately only, but it is written in one table as shown here. Now, since now if you see here, one number is 12 and the other is 15. Now 15 being an odd number cannot be divided by 2. Correct? It is not divisible by 2. So what we'll do, we'll keep 15 as it is. Okay, we'll carry down 15 as it is and we'll divide 12 by 2. So we know that 2 sixes is 12. Correct? So we'll write 6 here and bring down 15 as it is. Now again 6 can be divided by 2. So again we'll divide it by 2. So we know that 2 threes is 6. Correct? So we'll write 3 and again bring down 15 as it is. Okay, so now here we have 3 and 15. So we'll divide by 3. Okay, so 3 ones are 3 and we know that 3 fives is 15. Correct? So now we have got 1 and 5. Okay, so now we'll divide 5. This 1 what is there first, we'll keep it as it is. And this 5 will divide by 5. So 5 ones are 5. Okay, so you have to divide until you get 1 and 1. Okay, so now to find the LCM, what you will do, you will find the product of all the divisors. So these are the divisors. So that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Okay, so when you multiply all that, you will get the LCM as 120. Okay, so when you find a number which is not divisible by that divisor, so you will just bring it down till you get a divisor for that. Okay. We'll see one more example. So here they have asked you to find LCM of three numbers, 55, 75 and 150 by common division method. Okay, so 55, 75 and 150. So since all you see these three numbers, then you can realize that they are all divisible by 5. Correct? So we'll start dividing it by 50. So 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5, so 11. Then when we'll divide 75 by 5, so 5 ones are and 5 5s are 25. Okay, and 5 30s are is 150. Now here 15 and 30 can be further divided by 5, but 11 cannot be. So we'll ignore 11 and just divide 15 and 30 by 5. So we'll bring down 11 as it is and we'll divide 15 by 5. So 15 by 5 is 3. So we write 3 here, and 5 6 is 30, so we'll write 6 now. Okay, so now we have 11, 3 and 6. Correct? So now what we'll do, we'll divide by 2. Okay, because it's the smallest and 6 can be divided by 2, we'll divide by 2. So ignore 11 and 3, bring them down as it is, then do 2 3s are 6. Okay, so now we have 2 3s here, so we can divide by 3. So ignoring 11, we'll divide by 3. So this 11 will come down as it is. Then we have 3 ones are 3 and 3 ones are 3. So we got 2 ones now. So this 11 will divide by, since it's a prime number, we'll divide 11 by 11. So 11 ones are 11. So we got all ones here now. So to find the LCM, you'll multiply all these divisors. So 5 into 5 into 2 into 3 into 11. So when you multiply all that, you'll get 1650, which is the LCM for 55, 75 and 150. Alright, so now let's solve the questions that are there in your textbook. Okay, so exercise 3.4. Okay, exercise 3.4 in your textbooks, page number 119. Alright, so here question 1, 2 and 3. Let's do that now. And here question number 4, they have told to do at home. So find the LCM by common division method and check by prime factorization. So basically you have to do both the methods, and if you both the answers are same, it means you have checked your answer and your answer is correct. Okay, so this question is for homework. Okay, this question is for homework. And in question number 1, question C is for homework. Okay, in question 2, B and C both are for homework. You have to try to do it on your own. If I do everything, then you all will not be able to solve everything on your own. Okay, and this question B is for homework. So these and the rest of the questions we'll solve now. Okay, so let's solve these questions. So just mark the questions which are there for your homework. All right. So first question, find the LCM by listing the multiples, correct? So first question is find the LCM by listing the multiples. Okay, so for a question 12 and 15, so we have to find LCM of 12 and 15. Okay, so first what we'll do, we'll write a few multiples of 12. So I have written here 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72 and 84. Okay, then we'll write the multiples of 15. So 15, 30, 45, 60, 75, 90, 105 is what I've written. Now just see what are the common multiples here. So we have 60 as one common multiple, correct? So we have 60. Then is there any other multiple which is common among 12 and 15? There's no other multiple. It means that the LCM of 12 and 15 is 60. Okay, LCM of 12 and 15 is 60 itself. Now same way, question B, find the LCM of 9 and 12. So here 9 and 12, first we'll write multiples of 9. So I have 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63 and 72. And multiples of 12, 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72 and 84. Okay, so what are the common multiples between 9 and 12 now? So we have 36, correct? So we have 36 in both 9 and 12. And we also have 72 as a common multiple for both 9 and 12. Now, between 36 and 70, which is the lowest common multiple or the lowest multiple, that is 36. So 36 is the LCM for 9 and 12. Okay, so that is 9 and 12 is the LCM, 36 is the LCM for 9 and 12. So this was question number 1, A and B. Okay, now we'll do question number 2A. Okay, so for 2A, I have find the LCM by prime factorization. So here we have 24 and 42. Correct. So first we'll find LCM of 24 by division method. Okay. Sorry, not LCM, prime factors of 24 by LCM division method. Okay, so here I have 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Correct. Then we have 2 6s are 12 and 2 3s are 6. So the prime factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Correct. And for 42, we have 2 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2 and then 3 7s are 21. So prime factors of 42 are 2 into 3 into 7. Now see what are the common factors for both 24 and 42. So we have 2 as a common factor, 1 2 as a common factor, correct? And we also have 1 3 as a common factor for both 24 and 42, right? So we'll write this 2 ones here, okay? This 2 ones, and this 3 is also common, so we'll write that 3. And the rest of the multiples which are not, or the factors which are not common, we'll write those. So we have 1, 2, 1 more 2 and 1, 7. So what are the, so how will you write? You'll write 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7. So when you multiply all that, you'll get the LCM as 168. Okay, 24 and 42 LCM is 168. Now, question 3, find the LCM by common division method. So question 3a, 48 and 72. So first we'll start dividing by 2. So we have 2 2's are 4, correct? And 2 4's are 8, so 24. Then here we'll get 36 when we divide. 2 3's are 6, we'll have a remainder of 1, and 2 6's are 12, so 36. Okay, then again both are even numbers, so we'll divide by 2 only again. So I have 2 1's are 2, 2 2's are 4, that is 12. And then 36 divided by 2, when I do, I get 18. Okay, then again we'll divide by 2, so that will be 2 6's are 12 and 2 9's are 18. So we can further divide 6 by 12 but not by 2 but not 9. So we'll keep bring down 9 as it is and divide this 6 by 2. So I'll get 2 3's are 6 and bringing down that 9 as it is. Okay, now I have a 3 and 9 here, so we'll divide by 3. So 3 1's are 3 and this becomes 3 3's are 9. Then again, since 3 is there here, we'll divide it by 3. So this 1 will be the as it is and this 3 1's are 3. So we get 1. So the LCM will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, so when you multiply all that, you'll get 144. So 144 is the LCM for 48 and 72. Alright, and last problem for today, finding LCM of 100, 125 and 150. Okay, so first as usual, we'll start dividing by 2. So 200 divided by 2 is 50. Okay, we can't divide 120. 125 is not divisible by 2. So we'll bring it down as it is. Then 150 divided by 2 is 75. Okay, then again 50 here is still divisible by 2. So we'll divide 50 by 2, we'll get 25. And bring down 125 and 75 as it is. Okay, now since 25 and 125 cannot be divided by 3, but 75 can be divided by 3. So you can divide 75 by 3, or what you can do, since all are ending with 5, it means that it is divisible by 5. So you, leaving 3, you can start dividing by 5 first, but later on somewhere a 3 will remain. So that time you can divide by 3, or you can do how I have done here also, it's no problem. So I brought down 25 and 125 as it is and divided 75 by 3, I got 25. Now all are divisible by 5, so we'll divide by 5. So 5 5's are 25, 5 25's are 125 and 5 5's are 25. So I got 5, 25 and 5. Again we'll divide by 5, so this becomes 1. This is 5 5's are 25 and 5 1's are 5. Correct. So 1 5 is left, so we'll divide by 5 again. Now we got all 1's here. So 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 5 is the LCM. So when you multiply all that, you'll get the answer as 1500. So LCM for 100, 125 and 150 is 1500. Okay, so I hope you all have understood how to find LCM. In the next class, we will see how to do HCF. So I've told you which problems to do for homework. Complete your homework. And then we'll, as I told, we'll do HCF in the next class. Alright, thank you.